series of paintings based on Van Gogh drawings. So this is a previous project, but I'm not quite done with it and still needs to dry a little bit. So this is an oil painting, so oil takes a little bit of time to dry, which I'll probably need, like, I could probably start again tomorrow to really put on the finishing touches. But for now, it's not dry enough to the point where I can really work on it, because, you know, the paint's going to start spreading and I'm just going to get, and it's going to be really difficult to work with. So I'm going to start another painting based on a drawing by Vincent. And that one is going to be titled, or it is titled, Sien with Umbrella with Girl, or with Umbrella and Girl, I think. Sien with Umbrella and Girl. It's funny because this image has a little girl standing to the side of Sien. So if you don't know the history of Vincent van Gogh, Sien is a woman that he had a relationship with, and she had a baby, and it was very controversial because she was a prostitute. And back in those days, I mean, even today, back in those days, especially having children with prostitutes, especially Vincent van Gogh was an evangelical religious, you know, his grandfather was like a preacher. So, you know, and eventually, like, he went away from evangelizing. Obviously, he became a painter. But what's interesting is that there's a little girl, and it was rumored at those times that it was his child. But they never admitted to it, so we'll never find out. No one will ever know if it was his child. She was a prostitute, so, you know, it could have been anybody's. I don't know exactly the situation there. But yes, there was a lot of controversy back then, and who knows? Maybe one day they will have a DNA test and find that Vincent was in fact the father. But as for this drawing, it's pretty easy to look up. It is in the, you can pretty much find it in many places, but it is Sien Under Umbrella with Girl, I think, or with Girl Under Umbrella, or something like that. It is in the title of this in the title of this video, of this live stream. I don't always remember the titles and names of all the paintings. So one thing that was challenging with this painting up here that I'm gonna work on . So I want both of them to be on here. One thing that was challenging with this painting up here was that it was, I did it differently. So this next painting, I want to stay much looser, and I'll use like a much looser brush, a bigger, more fun and exciting brush. So I'm going to try to do it, the majority of it, with this filbert brush. Filbert is a rounded brush, basically. I'm going to try to do the majority of it with this. Keep it nice and loose, because if you look at his early paintings around, you know, 1882, 1883, 1881, didn't really quite have a finish. He was just really intently focused on painting. Like, he would paint anything. And with this one, so some of the colors I want to use, let's see, let's go with I think that's a dark brown, which works. A lot of browns, blacks. Let's go with a light cobalt blue. Let's pull out our cobalt blue here. Deep gray. Painting's much easier when, you know, you have the, if you're like dealing with another painting and you can see what colors are being used if you're just trying to copy another painting. But when you're not painting, you have to really depend, and fortunately, Vincent van Gogh was very good at this, but you have to depend on the drawing and a person's ability to depict values And then you really gotta imagine and guesstimate what colors were being used in that situation. So, let's see here. I'm gonna pull out my tube of white. I always need a white. White is like my most used color. Gone through at least a few tubes of white. Just constantly need to like lighten colors up and stuff. So setting up my tube station right now. Oops. And let's see what colors might we want to use. We got the blues, got the browns. She looks like she's pretty much wearing like a black dress and like a white shawl. I'll give her a red shawl. Play like a dark red shawl. So let's work with this. And my goal here is to stay pretty loose. So we're gonna get our basic idea here. We're gonna start with a brown, black. Let's dip it in some oil to get started. And we want our main color to be like a brown, black, or a brownish, dark navy blue. So we're gonna start with this, get it nice and oily. And let's see, so. Get her figure. The figure of an umbrella here. Let's see, let's do some speed painting. Just keeping it pretty loose. I'm gonna go with some speed painting. So how many edges? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's going to come down. That's like that, that, and like that. And let's go with Sien's head right around here. And her head's gonna come around. We're gonna get her body. The rest of her body is gonna come around here. Just getting this very loose sketch going. This is gonna be rounded out a bit more. And it's gonna, her shoulder's gonna come right down around here, getting the overall body shape here. Sien. And the elbow comes down just a little bit further, so the body's gonna come down. Her dress is gonna come down right around there. We're gonna bring this dress around just quickly sketching this out, quickly sketching out our figure. This is, let's see, so she's it's almost like she's leaning on this leg, and here we go, she's got some type of belt there, and her arm gonna come down right around there, and this is just keeping a nice loose sketch, getting the full body. So probably be about the bottom of the head to the top. Just this piece alone is her dress. So we're gonna go with her dress, comes down, comes up, and then comes up a third time, and then comes out. Oh yeah, she's actually clutching her dress. So that's cool, that's perfect. All right, staying pretty loose with this. And there we go. So we're gonna go with some browns. Let's go with some browns. Browns and darks. Dark and brown. This is our main color. I'm gonna block this in. And let's block in actually some more shapes here. So we just gotta. Her hand is gonna be right around there. Her shawl, so not really getting the. It's gonna be the umbrella. Now let's get this little girl right here. So she comes up to about her shoulder. And there's a head right there. The size of her head is pretty big because she's got like this big hat on. And we're going to go down to right around there where she's going to. And her shoulders, her head's gonna end right around here. But her shoulders are gonna be drooping. Oh, this is pretty off because she needs to be basically like clutching her dress. So we're gonna move this over a little bit. We're gonna move this over our figure. It's gonna be right around here. Okay, that's a little better. So we're gonna reduplicate this. I'm gonna improve upon it. Body come down. Her feet. Oh yeah, let's get Sien's feet right here. Sien's feet, and then she's gonna have another foot that comes out like so. Sien's feet are gonna come out like that, and we're gonna get this dress right here. So estimate her hands right there, but the dress is gonna end slightly above. So quickly just coming up with our overall design here. And her feet. Let's see, her feet are gonna come down. The foot is going to come right down to right around there. And wow, there's so much empty space to the left here, but let's go. All right, let's paint around these figures now. Actually, I'm gonna fill this dress. It's gonna fill this dress. that is that. So we're gonna go clean this up. This is basically a dark cobblestone path. So I want to say the horizon line is probably somewhere back here. So we're going to set a horizon line. I'm going to go with like a... off-gray background. Let's go with a little bit of off-gray. So... and that's gonna come out right around top of her head. This is like a good spot. That's a good spot for a horizon line, huh? It's gonna come through here. So I'm gonna brush it pretty rough because there's rain. She's holding an umbrella, it's raining. That's gonna be a pretty rough brush whole way around. I'm gonna see if I get the idea of rain without actually this is going to be a much looser painting. Let's clean this tip off a little bit, just the tip. Now back to our rainy day. Fill the canvas with some light. And let's use some white. It is a rainy day, so we'll go ahead and now that's going to be an issue. Hopefully I can fix that with a lot of paint. I guess as it gets closer into the backdrop, can add more gray. Now let's see if we can make this piece work here. Easy part is almost done. Actually, I want to add a bit of our Prussian blue. Let's throw in some of our Prussian blue into here just to give it some more. More color, more fun. I'm being super loose. Ah, all right. Does it look like a blustery rainy day? Yes, it does. So we're doing okay. Now, time to work on our cobblestone path. Or maybe it's a dirt path. No, it looks like cobblestone. So cobblestone would definitely be like a, almost like a, we're gonna make this overall feel very muted. A dirty, muddy path. I mean, it's raining, so it's got to be muddy. It's got to be a little dirty. So throw in some brown with our gray. And there we go. Let's brighten this cobblestone up a little bit. Be strategic. What is a good color? We'll go with Prussian and white. A brown, actually, again. At some point, I will make these look like cobblestones by literally just painting in lines, which should be pretty easy. But for now, just want to get space around our characters. And let's do that. Let's do some space around the characters. Thank you. getting in our space, and once we're done with this area, these areas around their feet. Once we're done with the ground that they walk on, we'll move on to their bodies. Okay. Okay.
Cleaning up our brush right now. And we're going to
start moving on to the figure here. So let's get this umbrella. Let's fill this umbrella in. You know, fill out the major blocked shapes. Should be pretty easy. Just want to be careful around the head, because the head right here is going to be mostly white. Actually, you know, I might go with like a red. I can basically do whatever color. It's not, you know, since it's a drawing. But I just know, like, early in Vincent's paintings, which I find really interesting, is that he uses a lot of very dark colors. Totally different than what he eventually uses later on. So it's just interesting to see the transformation over the years of his art and painting style, which, you know, as an artist myself, I look forward to being able to look at his later pieces, which, you know, right now I'm studying his early pieces just because kind of like the idea of seeing how he evolved as an artist. I find that very interesting. So some of these umbrellas, I got an umbrella shape. I want to add some textures, some details that are a little bit harder to notice, but very subtle details that can make a difference in your painting. And that's simply painting into the direction, or even drawing into the direction where the lines should be. So if you could tell, I am painting into the direction of the umbrella. It's almost like a, I like how it kind of like disappears into this background here. So let's continue on with let's give try and decide on these colors. Let's go with a very dark brown again. We're just gonna keep going with this dark brown. Maybe give her a little bit more color. We'll give her like a dark red. Add some red into this. Thank you. add some yellow. Okay. It's gonna be a belt. I'm gonna give our okay, let's continue on this color. The whole dress is probably a similar color. And honestly, I think this should be a little higher. Let's give her some extra long legs. Actually, you know what? We could just keep painting this through because eventually we're going to give her... We're eventually going to give her... Let's see, where is my brown? We're eventually gonna give her a belt, and we could basically put that belt anywhere, is what I wanted to say. Okay, here's our Van Dyke brown. I use so much of this. I really wish these tubes would like fit into our little squeezer here, but they don't. Oh no, there's a hole. That's not good. There's a hole that has appeared. Which I hope that doesn't affect. Well, I guess it definitely will affect, but we gotta try to suss this out. I guess that could really dry out the paint here. So we're gonna have to. Oof. Oh well. Gotta get new gloves. believe he cut off his own ear. Vincent, this guy. Man, cut off his own ear. He was quite the character. And while I wouldn't necessarily ever hang out with him, you can't help but just be in awe of a lot of the work that he created. And I'm trying to figure out this. Oh yeah, that is an empty space. So I'm giving her like a maroon dress. Create some more separation a little bit. But for now, let's give this save some space for her hands. What would go good with the red? Red, orange, purple, and red. Give our character down here a similar color, maybe. Actually, you know what we should do right now? Let's go and start to sketch, draw out the hands. We're just gonna paint out the hands a little bit. Paint out the faces and hands. Let's do that. I'm gonna go with like a reddish. Some red, orange, yellow. Super browned. And some white here. A little more white, even more white. Okay, I think that's good. Let's get our hands, which should be a similar color. So her hand is gonna come up and it's gonna be clutching an umbrella. Before I paint into there, I want to paint the rest so I don't get too much of this other color onto my brush. Now let's get this. Let's get this girl's face. This little kid. There we have that. Add another hand here. Design this section a little better. Let's go. My hand is gonna come right around here. Little thumb. This little girl's thumb. Maybe a little lower, let's see. Let's get a little lower. There we go. This. Lighten this area. All right. Okay, back to this. Let's start to sketch out her shawl. We're gonna give her a light blue. Let's give her a pink headgear. I'm gonna come back to this brush here. I'm gonna give her a pink headgear. It's the very light pink. Let's see. So this is probably gonna come around. I just felt like the pink was too close to the skin color, but it might be okay. So we're gonna go around the head here. We're gonna go, she's got some hair there. Is gonna come around. Let's just use the same color for both the girl, you know, this like pink, off pink, red, purple, mauve, whatever you want to call it. And we're going to go use a similar color for our character here. So we're going to go see her hair a little bit, so I'm gonna leave some space here. We actually need to block out her outfit. So how are we gonna do that? Let's go. Something pink. You know what? I could just use this to paint it, because the dark parts I can just paint over. That's easy. All right, and that's good. Let's bring in some brown hair. Sien is also going to have some brown hair. I'm going to give them both brown hair.
They're probably related.
Okay.
Alright.
Back to our dress. So, this dress is gonna come around. I think it's so funny. She left this little girl out of the umbrella. The umbrella doesn't even cover the little girl. It's hilarious in this drawing. I wonder why. It's not nice. It's just an amusing observation in this painting. Or in the drawing itself that I am painting. Just left this little girl to tolerate the rain by herself. It's probably not her daughter. I guess parenting was different back in the day, huh? That's my only guess. It was less about self-sacrifice and more about the family unit, I guess. I don't know. Also, given that, again, Sien was a prostitute. So, you know, I'm not trying to say that anything negative about that, but maybe she was not the type of mother we might expect from a modern parent, right? That's what I'm trying to say. And let's cover this up, this finger. Okay, shoot this area. Off this brush. All right, and final touches.
Yes.
Do these shoes. I'm gonna do them with like a bluish green. It's still blue green. And a little girl will have darker, she's gonna have darker shoes. So I'm gonna have to update that a little bit, but overall we are doing okay. See what we can do. So that's like a green. Let's fill in this space with some of that color here. Line it up a little bit. Ah, I'm remembering that color. Gray, use a little bit of this powerful gray that we've been using. You're home already? Okay, you're right. Oh. How was the rehearsal?
Oh, it was good. Yeah, it was actually good.
Yeah? Good.
It's good. It's very exciting.
You said it's very exciting?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, it's a mob. I'm the head of the mob.
You are?
Yep.
That's cool.
Yeah. And I kill people.
I'm recording, by the way.
Hello, people. Is it a new one?
That's a new one.
Oh, you finished the guy. Oh, cool.
I didn't finish him yet.
Oh, you didn't? You just got bored?
No, it needs to dry.
Oh. Okay, cool.
Yeah, I needed to give it time to dry
a little bit. You didn't drink your coffee.
I drank some of it.
Two sips?
Yeah.
What does this go?
I thought that was part of your belly ring.
No, but it looks like it.
It's maybe a shower curtain?
I don't know, it's broken.
I thought it was your belly ring.
Edible in here, what is it? Smell test. Oh my god, I had this chicken to cook. I forgot about it. Okay, it's still good? It's still in the fridge. See?
Maybe. I don't know. I was expecting fish tonight.
I haven't gone to the store yet. I was at the rehearsal, and I have to use the bathroom.
Okay. Nervous. I'm just saying.
I know. You want fish, but... I thought I had food. I didn't see it the other day, so I'm like, oh, maybe we ate it all. Hot dog, this is good for me, right?
Yeah.
Chicken's so good. It's so good. Bread?
What is that?
It's the bread.
Oh, the focaccia?
Yeah.
Nah, it's probably not good.
I'm gonna start eating stuff that's in the
You're the one who always says, oh, I'm going to eat it for my leftovers. You never do.
I know. I do. I eat leftovers every day. But there's just so many of them. It's just me. I just eat peanut butter jelly. Cookie cake. Cookie
Oh, that's probably bad. The what? Okay. Not right now. Not right now. And let's do, I need to tighten up this hand a little bit more. Also, I gotta do this face. So let me do the face and then do the hand.
Actually tastes better than it did the night
before. Oh yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Good. What are you barking about?
Vern was practically inside the trash can.
This figure looks like a very young chef. A very short chef. Alright, let's tighten them up. Tighten this character up. So we need a little bit of our pink. So we've got a what we also need is some stripes on this thing. Thank you. What are we gonna do at this face? My goodness. What a face. Okay, babe, you gonna puke? You made sounds for four straight seconds.
Excuse me?
Said you made sounds for four straight seconds.
You counted how long I was making sounds?
Yes.
Why don't you have better things to do?
Well, I'm working on this. About as far as we're gonna push this piece for now. Maybe we'll work on it again another day, but I'm gonna call this a wrap on these pieces for today. So for those of you that tuned in, thank you. We will be back on another day, but you know, I think it's always good to have some words of inspiration. And with that, I read this great book. It's called The Power of Now. And it's pretty popular and, you know, a bit controversial because it doesn't really teach you any specific skill. It just talks about a spiritual concept. And the main idea is that observing your thoughts, not thinking about those thoughts, but just observing them, is basically a helpful spiritual practice. And that said, you know, it's been very helpful to me, this idea of just observing your thoughts, not letting them control you or anything like that. But when you observe your thoughts, it helps you accomplish things because you start to become aware of the things that hold you back, the things that limit yourself. And what you choose to do with your thoughts is quite important. But with that said, we're done with this. So it might be a book worth checking out. Power of Now by Eckhart Tolle. And for now, we're going to call this a wrap on these two paintings. And thank you for tuning in if you did, and have a great day.